It all started at Democracy Bar, where everyone wants to buy a drink for the hottest guest, Candy Date. It's the late 1970s. Regular Joe walks in and buys a drink or two for Candy Date. They talk about potholes and parks, but Richie Rich wants more FaceTime. But, oh snap, there's a tab limit! Thanks to a brilliant Supreme bartender, Buckley Vallejo, she said, without a tab limit, the Richie Riches of the world would hog all of Candy Date's attention with endless drinks, and they'd simply become too friendly. She'd owe him one, and she'd know exactly what he wants in return. Or, as the bartender pointed out, there was a risk of corruption. But in 2010, a new Supreme bartender is around, and Richie Rich's company, Citizens United, decides to help Candy in a different way. The company wants to pick up the tab for everyone at the bar, in honor of Candy. As long as Citizens United agrees not to speak to Candy anymore. That independence is why the new Supreme bartender doesn't see any risk of corruption here. But then, a few months later, a pack walks in, Speech Now, and says, hey, Junior Judge Bartender DC, your boss said Richie's company is independent, because that limits the risk of corruption. I'm independent too. If independence limits corruption, let me accept unlimited money from whoever I want. Junior Judge Bartender DC says, the boss ain't around right now, but fair point, go for it. But that Supreme Bartender is gonna be mad when he gets back, because Junior didn't think that all the way through. Richie whispers so loudly that Candy looks over and sees him say, hey, Speech Now, I'll give you the money, you buy everyone drinks in honor of Candy, and I'll go mingle with Candy. Candy is excited to have Richie as a supportive friend, and Richie is excited to have Candy's support in the halls of Congress. Uh-oh, court made a mistake, but to bring this shady allegory back to reality, Buckley said, you can limit contributions to candidates, but you can't limit spending on candidates, because that's independent, that's free speech. Citizens United said, the same goes for corporations, they have free speech too. And then Speech Now delivered the dagger. Corporations can spend whatever they want on contributions to political action committees because, hey, the political action committees are independent. But see the flaw here? Those corporations aren't independent, and those corporations aren't really spending. The super PAC is. The company is contributing. And according to Buckley, contributions from folks who aren't independent, the companies, raises enough of a risk of corruption to allow Congress to impose limits. The court swung and missed big time. How do we know? The rush of money and corruption that followed. In 2012, a billionaire funneled $500K through a super PAC to get a yacht marina approved. In 2017, mega donors flooded into PACs to get their taxes cut by Congress. In 2018, Senator Menendez traded favors for donations to a super PAC supporting his re-election. In 2020, millionaires donated to a pro-Trump PAC to get a Ukraine ambassador fired. Clearly, there was a risk of corruption in Speech Now. The corruption is literally happening all around us. So if you're wondering how money crept its way back into politics, it all started at Democracy Bar.